guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Renee, and if you didn't know this about me, I own an ice cream shop. I am a small business owner, and in today's video, I'm going to answer one of your most prominent questions. Has the pandemic affected my small business? And I'll tell you now, the answer is yes. The pandemic and everything that is going on around the world has had a huge, dramatic, mainly negative effect on my ice cream shop, and I'm gonna explain that to you in detail. I'm getting ready to go to work. It's Friday afternoon. Of course, we're open on Friday night. It's the middle of the summer. I'm gonna take you to the ice cream shop with me, and I'm gonna share some of my answers along the way. So are you ready for some ice cream? Let's go. Let's go to Cravin' the Curls. So I'm in the shop. Nobody's here yet. I have about 30 minutes to record this video for you all before my staff starts showing up and we start the opening process. But one of the ways the pandemic has affected our business is custom products and shipping. We have these super cute custom made ice cream cups. These are printed overseas. Y'all, did you know there is only one or two companies in the United States that does custom printed cups like this, and they are so expensive. So it's gotta be done. I get these overseas. I order these cups 40,000 at a time. And when I ordered these last year, I planned ahead. I ordered them in advance to be ready for this year. It took me 6 months to get my cups. 6 months. There is a huge shipping issue. Anything that is coming from overseas has a shipping problem. Do you remember seeing on the news back in the springtime when a big cargo ship got caught in this canal and none of the ships could get through? Shipping has still not recovered from that. One of the main ports in Hong Kong where things are shipped out of to the United States was shut down for like a lot of weeks because there was an outbreak of COVID there. So currently, at the filming of this video, which is the very end of August in 2021, there is a backlog of ships trying to get into the port. In California, I think I heard today there are 30 ships in waiting, trying to deliver products into the United States. Thank goodness I have my cups for the year, but I'm gonna have to order again in probably November to get them in time for next season. And another thing shipping has affected, huge, huge thing, is our ice cream machines, our rolling machines. They are made for us, again, overseas. There is not a single manufacturer in the United States. Our machines have been in use for 5 years. They are on 10 hours a day, 6 days a week. We needed new machines. I have four new rolling machines ordered. They are custom made for me, for Cravin' the Curls, exactly the way I want them, and they have been on a ship trying to get in the United States for almost 2 months now. 2 months, my machines, I've been waiting, y'all, I'm waiting, and I can't get them. They are stuck on a cargo ship. So again, that is another example of huge shipping problems. Then there is the price of things, the price of almost everything I use on a daily basis in our ice cream shop has skyrocketed, and I'm not even joking. Let me give you a couple examples. Vinyl food gloves. This is a health code requirement. If you're touching food, you gotta have on food gloves. We buy these gloves by the case. A case of vinyl gloves, which is 1,000 gloves, and it's a pretty good guess. We go through a case of gloves about every 2 weeks. A case of vinyl gloves before the pandemic ran, you know, $43, something like that. Currently, I'm paying about $75, $80 for a case of these gloves. So that is a huge difference. Another example of the price of everything going up. Strawberries. Big, beautiful fresh strawberries, just like this one. It is a staple at Cravin' the Curls. Strawberries are in our number one selling flavor of ice cream. We don't buy processed strawberries, pre-chopped strawberries. We use fresh, whole strawberries. And the customer sees us cut the top off and put a whole strawberry in their ice cream. This is a 2-pound package of strawberries. In a typical week at Craving the Curls, we will go through about 50 pounds or 25 of these. These normally run $3.50, maybe $4. Lately, strawberries have been running about $8, up to $8.50 for the same package. That is double my food cost to make our best-selling flavor of ice cream. Just think about all of the products that go into your food, the things that are used to make your food, and I promise you, the prices of everything have gone up. Let's just talk about the labor shortage. You hear it all over the news, and last year, I honestly did not have a labor problem. This year, it's been a completely different story, and y'all, it is real. There is a labor shortage. Let me explain. This year, we have 20 teenagers who work at Craving the Curls. 11 of those teenagers left for college. They were either going off for their freshman year, or they were kids that have worked for us for a very long time, went off to college, and came home to work for the summer. Well, I knew we were going to have a hard time. Losing 11 kids was going to be tough. I could see it coming all summer long. So I've been trying to hire kids who come in the door, you know, customers getting ice cream. Put the fact that we're hiring on our Facebook page, our Instagram page. I have a sign at the register that everybody sees when they come in. I've had it posted on the front door. I have even sent information to the local high schools asking them to help me find kids that need a job or want a job because we are hiring and I can't find anybody. Nobody wants to work. Teenagers don't want to work. And I get it, partly. It is fall, school's back in season. Teenagers sort of like freak out this time of year because school is overwhelming. There's sporting events they want to go to at night or on the weekend. They want to be out with their friends. They're in school all day and they just want their freedom. So typically, high schoolers don't want to work when school's in session. So at this moment, I'm down to 7 staff members. 7 staff. So that has led me to having to change our hours, which has honestly been the hardest part for me during this whole ordeal. We are always open 6 days a week. We're closed on Mondays. That's when our food is delivered. We clean the floors. I'm in here cleaning. We got to have a day to like regroup in here, but we're always open Tuesday through Sunday. And this is the first week of our new hours. We have had to close during the week. We are no longer open on Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday. I've got nobody to work. We're now only open Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And on Fridays, we don't even open till 5. That's it. And it's just unfortunate. And I know customers are probably not happy with me about that, but honestly, I don't have a choice. I have been trying for months to bring in some new employees and I just can't find anybody. So many of my viewers on YouTube stop in Craving the Curls to see me and I love it. I love meeting you. I love chatting with you. So if you're planning on coming to Craving the Curls, just know I'm only here on the weekends now, guys. Only on the weekends. We're in a small town. Downtown Paducah, Kentucky. We're by the river. It's a tourist town. We have a very loyal, great community of people that love to support their downtown businesses. We have festivals. We have all kinds of stuff going on in the streets pretty much from like April to October. Last year and this year, all of that stuff has been canceled. Our big 4th of July fireworks and celebration, canceled. We have a huge barbecue festival that takes place literally at my front door. It is a 3-day, huge, gigantic barbecue festival that brings about 40,000 people to downtown Paducah over the course of 3 days. Canceled 2 years in a row. When we don't have those huge events that we come to count on, it really does hurt us financially. So the last thing I'm going to tell you is about like upkeep to the shop. We've been here for 5 years and I feel like it's time to do some upgrades to Craving the Curls. There are just some changes I want to make, some upgrades I want to make that when we first opened, because I didn't know if we would be successful or not, I was afraid to spend the money on some things like tables and chairs. We had planned to buy all new tables and chairs for our entire ice cream shop. And by the way, we seat 30 people. I'm afraid to do that. Like, it's a huge chunk of money, and I'm afraid to spend the money because I don't know what the next year's going to bring. Do I need to hang on to that money? Something tells me yes. We already spent a large chunk of money buying the new machines that I told you about that I still don't have. And in the middle of the year, our register died. The software that we were using for the past 5 years just... And I'd had so many problems with them, their hardware, their software, that I just decided to go with a whole new company. So we did have to buy a whole new cash drawer, terminal, software, payroll system, like the whole thing, brand new. So that was a huge chunk of money. So there's just so many unknowns. We're just going to keep on plugging along and see what happens. But it's Friday night. We open in an hour. I'm going to show you what goes on at Craving the Curls on a typical weekend. I hope it's a typical weekend. And one thing I bet you don't know about YouTube. YouTube has a very strict regulation about showing children in videos. It's like a big violation. I'm going to film tonight. I'm not going to show our customers because I honestly don't want to film our customers. That would make me uncomfortable if I went in somewhere to eat and they were like filming me. But I will show you what goes on back here behind the line. I'll show you us rolling ice cream. I'm just not going to show you the faces of any of my teenage staff, but I will show you what rolled ice cream is, and you can kind of see what we do at Craving the Curls and get a feel for the best ice cream around. Now I gotta get going, guys. I gotta get this place open, and I got a lot to do. My staff is getting ready to show up. It's 4 o'clock right now. I'm gonna be here till probably 11:30 tonight, but I'll see you later. I gotta roll some ice cream. Well, that's it, folks. I'm the last one here. It's now 11 o'clock on a Friday night. The staff is gone, the place is clean, and I'm heading home. But that's my insight on how the pandemic has changed my small business. It's just a thing, y'all. I gotta roll with it. I'm making the best of it that I can, and hopefully when we get in 2022, things will be back to normal. I would love to just have normal. I know we all would. But for now, good night.